how were you? Hey, let's just drop your bags off at the desk and I'll run you right over to the grid.
For Christ's sake, Vernon, what's the fucking hurry? We're not even playing there.
We got any x-ray, I told you.
We could wait for 5 minutes, can't he? We don't want him on our backs.
So why do I even bother coming?
Vernon, please don't start that shit.
Come on, man, don't get all uppity. He's not a bad person.
He won't pay us.
Oh, it's an influential venue.
Vernon, he won't pay us.
We're just dropping off the bags. We'll be back in an hour.
Got a face left to blame.
All we get is dead disco, dead funk, dead rock and roll. Remodel everything. It's been done. La 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 la.
Regarding the new stuff, the best I can do is Crux. They're pretty excited. Through this new label out of Austin, Texas, the advance is pretty much symbolic, but I can get you a good percentage.
Yeah, yeah, what's their distribution? Around Austin at the back of a van or something?
No, all over the continent, in alternative record stores. But if it turns into a really breaks out, there's nothing stopping them from signing it over to a major.
Hang on one second. Wasn't I doing that deal?
Yeah, you were supposed to be 3 months ago.
I told you I'm in discussions with two major labels here.
Yeah, well, I think it's time we took what we could get.
You're hawking Lee's music at bargain basement prices and you
anything,
don't give
okay?
A fuck.
I'm being realistic. I'm in the real world.
What do you mean by that, the real world?
Well,
real
I mean
world?
As opposed to some psychedelic junkie fantasy world, just for instance. I'm being straight with you.
Do you realize what this bullshit deal would do to Lee's career?
It's as good as he's gonna get.
What? I can do better than that in 2 phone calls.
2 phone calls? Really? Don't let me stop you. Be my guest. Make your fucking phone calls. Go ahead, make your phone calls. It's not my fault, his reputation is shit.
Are you trying to say that it's mine?
Yeah, I am. So keep out of my way or I will slap you down. You understand what I'm saying?
Vernon, you're gonna regret this.
No, I don't think so, because you're not even here. Okay? I don't even see you. I don't talk to you. I'm talking to Lee about his life and his work and his wife's ego is his fucking problem. Emily, it's my fault. She pissed me off and I scared him away.
When is he gonna get rid of that woman?
I don't know, maybe if he stops shooting up for a day.
It's not gonna happen as long as he's with her. She's a junkie to the bone.
Yeah, that girl's a curse.
She's been bringing him bad luck for 5 years now.
What's their kid's name?
I can't remember. Jay,
it is.
Jay, yeah. Where is Jay?
Jay is in Vancouver with Lee's parents.
The hell are they doing in Vancouver?
That's where they're from. Lee's dad. They just moved back.
What's the point in having kids if you just dump them?
Tell him you got his number from Lewis. Mm.
Cheers. Is it working?
No, it's not working.
Oh, how come?
I don't fucking know. Look at this.
Oh, try... Hello? Lewis gave me your number and... Yeah. All right. Yeah. Hold on. Yes. Right, go on. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, got that. I'll be there. Now? Like in 15 minutes? Okay, I'll be there. Bye. I'm just going out for a bit, all right?
Yeah, right. See ya. You get what you wanted.
Yep.
Didn't like the way he spoke to Vernon, you know?
You liked the way he spoke to me?
No, I didn't, but you know he's right, don't you?
Come on, I told you. I'm waiting for DreamWorks to get back to me.
They don't give a shit at DreamWorks.
Oh, come on, that little slut Susan should go down on you anytime, anywhere, darling.
It's not Susan's decision who gets signed to fucking DreamWorks, is it?
Then whose is it, then?
I don't know who makes the decisions. I don't know anyone there anymore. How long ago did you send her those tapes, anyway? I said how long ago?
I don't know, maybe like 2 months.
2 months? And you still can't figure out why I had to get Verna to sort it out?
Actually, I don't. If you want me to give it away to some bullshit label, I could, anytime, no problem.
Look, I think it's pretty bloody obvious now that the problem is the record, it's not the fucking record label. Where's the bottle opener? Look, I'm 42. No one expects anything from me anymore. If I do something now, it's got to be absolutely exceptional. Or no one's going to give a fuck. And this record is anything but exceptional. It's just a lazy, shoddy, average piece of shit. And right, I might be off my face half the fucking time, but I know what I'm doing, you know? And I've done better than this. I fucking hope I have.
Well, then do better again.
What I'm saying is simple. Maybe next year, next week, next month, I'll do something better than this. But right now, all I'm worth is just this pathetic little bunch of songs. You know, absolutely fucking nothing.
You think it's my fault? My bad influence?
You always think just everything is based around you.
Did you read that article in Q? Oh,
forget about it. I can't stand this shit anymore.
Did you see what they wrote about me? How am I supposed to take that?
Look, we've been through this a million bloody times. I wish you'd just do yourself and do me a favour. Forget about it for 5 fucking minutes, right?
If you want to talk about drugs, let's talk about drugs.
Christ, no. That's all we ever talk about. I was just trying to talk about something else for a fucking change.
You're just like Vernon. You think the minute that you get rid of me, everything will be fine, right?
You're a fucking pain in the ass, Emily.
I'm out of here. I will leave you in peace to make your music, to rebuild your career,
do what you
right?
fucking like. I couldn't care less. Just leave me in peace. I could really do it.
Thank you. No, no, you can't be here.
Let go of me. I'm his wife. Let go.
I'll need to see some ID, please, man.
All right.
Get back here.
Miss Wang, you admit to knowing about Lee Hauser's drug problem. Did you supply him with the heroin that he overdosed with? And the heroin you were carrying at the time of your arrest, where did you get that from?
I got it from Lee Hauser.
And where did he get it from? All right, he died at 4 a.m. Where were you at that time?
I was sleeping in a car by the lake.
And did anybody see you there?
I don't think so.
All right, you admit yourself to being addicted to drugs.
Yeah.
And for how long have you been using heroin?
How you doing? Looking for Mr. Hauser.
Yeah, he's looking gold over there. Yeah.
Thanks, guy.
You felt like some blood.
No, thanks.
You sure?
Come on, darling. Yeah, get your napkin. I'll call you for afternoon tea. You finish the drawing for Grandpa.
The hotel clerk's deposition is pretty much in your favor. He said he saw you leave way before Lee died. And you didn't provide the drugs. If you plead guilty for possession, you should get off pretty lightly. Don't expect to go home tomorrow. Are you with me here?
Yeah, I'm not feeling too well. I'm on methadone.
Hits you pretty hard off the top.
Does it get better?
Depends on the person. Not for me.
What did the lawyer say?
Worst case, 6 months.
And the best case?
6 months. Oh, and yeah, I forgot to tell you, I signed a contract for Lee's record. He's obviously more interesting dead than alive. Plus, he got a ton of press. Way more than I would have expected. He was on the cover of Mojo.
Thanks for not sending it to me.
Well, the general tone with regards to you wasn't particularly flattering. So I fielded a bunch of offers, and I accepted the most prestigious. Of course, I'm joking, I mean the most lucrative. It'll pay some debts. And your lawyer's fees?
Thanks.
Don't thank me, I did it for Lee. You won't have to pay for a thing. And in return, I don't want you to ask me for anything ever again. When I walk through this door, I no longer exist. Just tell me this. Were you there when he died?
No.
Had you been fighting?
Yes.
Did you buy the stuff?
The doors to your left or to your right, to the right side of the building, spot 5. Thank you.
Here's your salad, sir. Everything over there. Vinegar, salt and pepper. Thank you.
Wouldn't you have preferred somewhere more private?
I'm really grateful that you came. You didn't have to.
I've been taking care of Lee's unfinished business, and it's mostly debts, as you know. I had to sell your apartment in London to pay them off. Of course, I had it empty. the receipt of where I put your things. It's in your name, and the address is right on it.
I'm not going back to London. Not right now. I'm going to go to Paris.
Is that where you lived before you met Lee?
Yeah.
I've worked things out with Barclays. And what was left of your joint account is now in your name. And your credit card is working again.
How much is left in the account?
Well, it's not much. It's enough to pay your way back. Maybe get by for a few weeks. And, not much more. If you want.
Oh, no, thank you. I'm fine.
I've been trying to work out lease contracts for the different record companies. The compilation. But it's like reading notes.
There's still a lot of unpublished stuff, mostly from the late 80s.
There's this friend of Lee's. He's been very helpful. This fellow Tricky.
He's famous.
Yes, I've heard.
A huge star.
I don't know his music, yeah, but they liked him. He's been faithful to their friendship. It's very unusual. Since Lee died,
it's a heroin substitute.
I'm sure your lawyer told you the court handed down this decision yesterday. Jay is staying with us. Father dead. Mother in prison.
Yeah. No home, no job, nothing.
Do you intend to appeal it?
No, of course not. I can't take care of him right now. You see the motel sign? It's right there. Thanks for the ride. You know your way back?
Well, more or less.
More or less? Well, don't get lost.
No. Emily. There's something I'd like to ask you. It's a bit delicate. You see, it was difficult to explain his father's death to Jay. I don't know what he thought or what he felt, but he's a well-adjusted boy, but he's sensitive. I'm scared. I'd prefer it if for the next few years you'd agree not to see him. Rosemary and I have done everything we can to give him some kind of stability, a home, a sense of belonging, and I'm afraid of unsettling him.
I understand.
Legally, you have the right to see him. But I think you should give him some time. We'll keep in touch. If you have any problems, we'll help.
Goodbye.
你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要去,你需要 Salut. Qu'est-ce qui s'est passé, là?
C'est rien. J'en peux plus, ce boulot de maître, c'est tout.
Bon, ben, j'ai pas pu t'avoir d'ordonnance, et en plus, je suis hyper inquiet. Ça fait 4 jours que j'arrive pas à joindre Alexis chez lui, il répond.
Mais je t'ai dit que j'étais à court.
Ouais, je sais, tu me l'as dit, et je t'ai dit aussi que je ferais ce que je peux. Bon, ben, faut y aller tout de suite.
C'est qui?
Aline, l'ex-copine d'Alexis. Ils sont séparés depuis longtemps, mais elle a gardé les clés de chez lui.
Quoi, ça m'emmerde un peu, ça fait un an et demi qu'on s'est pas parlé. Ça fait vraiment chier, quoi. En plus, j'ai déjà essayé tout à l'heure, il y a une chaîne. Tu vois, je t'avais dit.
Alexis!
Ça sert à rien, j'ai déjà essayé.
Bon, attends.
Qu'est-ce que tu fais?
Bah, laisse-moi le faire. On va d'abord nettoyer ce qu'il y a nettoyé, après on appellera la police. Passe-moi un sac. Tu devrais arrêter ces trucs-là. Hein.
Je t'emmerde.
Oula. C'est pas mes affaires. Hein. Tu fais ce que tu veux. Bon, bah alors, qu'est-ce que tu fais? Tu viens ou quoi?
Pourquoi tu m'as pas comme ça?
Oh ouais, tu m'as fait chier pour que je t'accompagne à la pharmacie de garde. Je t'ai accompagné. Maintenant, je retourne aider Aline.
Mais tu veux quoi? Que j'aille avec toi pour attendre les flics?
Si tu veux que je te dépose sur le chemin, je te dépose. Sinon, je te laisse là. Y a aucun problème.
J'ai pas besoin que tu m'aides. Je te fais pitié? J'ai pas besoin de pitié.
Oh là là, Émilie, ta gueule.
Tu t'intéresses à moi parce que j'étais la femme de Lee.
Tu m'emmerdes.
Dégage, dégage!
Ouais, bah pas besoin de me le dire deux fois.
Jean-Pierre! Tu m'as pas dit pour triquer?
J'ai eu le tour manager, il m'a dit qu'il te mettrait sur la liste des invités.
Mais je m'en fous de la liste des invités. Je veux juste deux fois cinq minutes.
Ouais, c'est ce que je lui ai dit, mais j'ai pas eu de retour.
Mais écoute, il faut que je lui parle.
Tu crois qu'il va t'aider à récupérer ton fils? Tu rêves? Regarde-toi, tu crois que t'es en état de t'occuper d'un enfant? Tu veux 20 euros pour prendre un taxi?
J'ai bien compris qu'on n'était pas les biscuits au système à Vedan. Le seul truc que moi je dis, c'est que j'aimerais bien faire une balance une fois dans ma vie.
Ouais, mais tu vois, il y a des mecs quand je joue avant vous et qu'on te déréglé. Je peux pas être partout à la fois.
C'est bon, je prends pas tout pour toi. À chaque fois, c'est la même histoire. Je suis juste en train de te dire que les organisateurs, c'est des enculés. Vendre de la bière, ça les connaît, mais la musique, ils en ont rien à battre. Et moi, ça me saoule.
Je prends tout pour moi parce que tu me parles mal et j'aime pas ça.
Ouais, c'est parce que je suis un peu vénère, voilà. Et donc, faut que ça sorte.
C'est des maquettes que j'ai fait avec Gloria. Je l'ai fait ce matin.
C'est qui Gloria?
Je n'ai souvent parlé d'elle. Je l'ai connue en prison.
Tu m'en vas mort, là.
Ouais, je t'en fous, tu m'emmerdes.
Comment c'était en tôle? C'était sa femme ou c'était la tienne?
Non, ça c'est chez les mecs. Pour nous, le problème, c'était de ne pas se faire violer par les gardiens. Mais si ça t'intéresse, je m'en suis bien sortie, merci. Enfin, heureusement qu'il avait des lettres, sinon tout le monde m'a oublié.
T'exagères.
Sauf les journalistes qui ont écrit des choses dégueulasses.
Oui, ici aussi.
Saute le premier et deuxième, c'est le remix pas très bien fait. Va directement à le 3.
C'est toi qui chantes?
Oui, j'ai écrit les textes aussi. La musique, c'est Gloria.
Toujours en tôle, Gloria?
Elle est impliquée dans un hold-up. En plus, un mec a été blessé. Elle est en prison depuis un an et demi. Elle n'a même pas été jugée.
Vous avez beaucoup de morceaux?
Une dizaine. Je sais que c'est pas du tout abouti, mais c'était fait dans des conditions très mauvaises.
Je sais pas quoi dire, je trouve ça ni bien ni mal. Ça ressemble à d'autres trucs, quoi.
Tu veux dire que c'est nul?
J'ai pas dit c'était nul. Allez, viens, il se casse.
Bonjour, je suis l'assistante d'Irène Paolini.
Oh, bonjour, suivez-moi.
En principe, elle devrait pas tarder, mais avec elle, on sait jamais, elle est toujours en retard. Moi, je passe mon temps à m'excuser à sa place. Franchement, c'est assez saoulant.
Oui, j'ai travaillé avec elle aussi.
Oui, je sais.
Vous savez?
Oui, je regardais votre émission chaque semaine sur le câble.
Quand je présentais les clips, style sur MTV avec un autre pétage.
Moi, je regardais l'émission pour vous. J'étais hyper fan. D'ailleurs, je le suis toujours.
Mais merci. Il est quoi, au moins, comme 6 ans? Vous aviez quel âge?
15 ans. J'étais au lycée. Je me coiffais comme vous, je m'habillais comme vous.
Merci.
Vous voulez boire quelque chose, un café?
Ah oui, je veux bien.
Je m'appelle Sandrine. On s'est parlé la semaine dernière.
Ah oui?
C'est moi qui ai transféré votre appel à Irène. Depuis, j'arrête pas de penser à vous. La nuit dernière, j'ai même rêvé de vous.
Et alors, c'était un bon ou un mauvais rêve?
Entre les deux. C'était dans un hôtel. J'avais rendez-vous avec vous et on me laissait pas entrer. Pourtant, c'était un hôtel très ordinaire. Je leur disais, je suis une amie d'Emily Wang. Ils ne croyaient pas et du coup, je devenais hystérique. Et je pleurais parce que j'étais de plus en plus en retard. Heureusement, Liozor était là. Il m'a reconnu et il m'a fait entrer. Mais quand on est arrivé dans la chambre, vous aviez disparu. Il y avait juste le lit défait.
Et ?
Mais rien. Je me suis réveillée. Et maintenant, vous allez rester à Paris ?
Je ne sais pas. Ça dépend de beaucoup de choses.
Ça dépend d'Irène Paolini ?
Il faut que je trouve un vrai boulot, que je fasse quelque chose de ma vie. Et pour l'instant, c'est pas génial. C'est vrai que je compte un peu sur elle.
Elle vous a proposé quelque chose de concret?
Non, rien. On s'est juste parlé au téléphone 2 minutes.
2 minutes? Ça m'étonne pas, elle s'intéresse qu'à elle. Et puis c'est plus comme à l'époque du câble. Maintenant, on travaille sur une chaîne généraliste, elle fait plus ce qu'elle veut. C'est hyper fliqué. Moi, j'ai eu envie de travailler avec Irène Paolini. Parce qu'à une époque, c'est quelqu'un qui a fait bouger les choses.
Oui, si vous voulez, un peu.
Mais maintenant, elle a renoncé.
Je vous trouve dur.
Non. Vous, vous avez pris des coups. Vous en avez donné aussi. On vous juge mal, mais vous n'avez pas renoncé. Et c'est pour ça que je vous respecte, et pas Irène Paolini.
Bon, bah écoute, j'ai pas pu lui parler. Ils sont arrivés très en retard, ils sont allés directement au soundcheck. Mais j'ai pu t'avoir un billet.
Merci.
Par contre, j'ai pas pu t'avoir de passe pour aller en backstage.
Mais tu m'avais dit que c'est possible.
Bah ouais, mais ils sont complètement maniaques, ils contrôlent tout. Moi, c'est à peine s'ils m'en ont donné un, c'est pour te dire.
Mais Tricky doit parler au père de Lee. Je veux revoir mon fils. Au moins, de temps en temps, c'est humain.
Ouais, bien sûr.
Je dois demander pas grand chose.
Bien sûr, bien sûr.
J'ai écrit une lettre.
Ah, ok.
Tu lui donneras.
Ce qu'on fait, c'est que tu m'appelles sur mon portable après le concert, te dire où est-ce qu'on va dîner.
D'accord.
Et tu nous rejoindras, ok? Ah, en fait, est-ce que tu as pu la joindre, Irène Paolini, là?
Non, elle m'a planté. J'attends qu'elle me fixe un nouveau rendez-vous.
Ah oui. Ouais, c'est bon, il a eu ton message. Hein. Ah ben non, je sais pas, c'est pas moi qui lui ai donné. Bon bah attends. Excuse me, petit. I have Emily, she's on the phone, and she's on the street, outside, on the... What should I tell her? Ok, bon bah écoute, apparemment c'est pas le moment. Tu vas? Ce que tu fais, c'est que tu nous rejoins à la sortie des coulisses. Tu vois où c'est? C'est sur la rue Comartin.
你死啊，老闆啊你啊！醫生都期望你自己搞掂。過嚟，你以後都唔使翻嚟。
做咩啊？
你應承我嘅嘢你冇做過，你個尊重你個家人。
佢哋有尊重我咩？如果係啊，我媽都唔會唔理我啦。
我當你自己係親生女一樣，借埋錢俾你，俾埋工你做。
咁嘅工，
唔夠好啊？
好。 你唔想幫中國人做嘢，你覺得好委屈嘛？我從來冇咁樣諗過喎。
我只係要求你一件事，你唔好帶毒品翻嚟。
呢度冇毒品啊？
講大話，你知唔知啊？我係醫度嘅負責人，你咁樣做法我會執笠嘅。
有冇貨？
我依家走，我以後都唔會翻嚟。你錢我還俾你。
唔使啦，我都唔諗住你會還翻啲錢俾我嘅。
Oh, sorry, I thought I was on time.
You're on time?
Yeah, okay. Come this way. So, are you staying long in London?
My wife's sick. She has to have some tests. It depends on the results.
Nothing serious, sir.
No.
These are the first drafts, for the cover graphics, the re-releases. A friend of Lee's did them. Morris Ott. Do you know him?
No.
He's very talented. He's a painter who's doing extremely well these days. Now, he doesn't normally do this sort of thing anymore, but for Lee, he made an exception. We're thinking of releasing all three albums at the same time, in September next year. As we agreed, nothing is definite until we get your approval.
I think he'd like that. A friend of his. A friend.
friend of Lee's did them.
Who?
Oh, God, I can't remember. A friend from London, I think.
Is that supposed to be Lee?
Yes, it's stylized. I think it's pretty good.
Doesn't look like him.
No, I think it does.
When? When did he look like that?
When he was young, when he first left and went to London, and we didn't hear from him for a while.
I read the liner notes you want to put with the CDs.
So did I.
I didn't think much of them.
No.
They give a false image of him.
Yeah.
As if there was nothing but drugs in his life.
And misfortune.
It's not true at all.
No. As journalists, they have this romantic idea of self-destruction.
Lee wasn't self-destructive.
Well, he did everything to excess.
No. Less than the friends he hung around with back then. They were all complete alcoholics. It's good they're re-releasing his records.
Yes, I'm happy about it.
In spite of a stupid liner note. I think they would have made him laugh too.
Yes. Was it gone too long?
No.
So what did you get up to? Did you watch a cartoon?
Yes.
What did you do when the cartoon was over?
I read.
You read? What'd you read?
I read M.D. Geist.
Thought you read that already.
No, I meant the new one.
I have to tell you something. We're gonna have to stay in London a bit longer than I thought.
Are we gonna stay at the hotel?
Yes. Do you remember how I told you that the specialist had to examine Grandma Rosemary because she had a very sore back?
Yes.
Well, they don't know what it is that causes the pain. So they have to keep doing these tests. So she's gonna stay in the hospital, and we're gonna stay together.
Are we gonna live in the hotel?
Yeah. The two of us are gonna stay in the hotel. Is that okay with you?
Yes.
Now, tomorrow you'll come with me, and we'll go visit Grandma Rosemary at the hospital.
Okay.
Excuse-moi pour l'autre jour, j'ai une réunion qui a débordé, j'étais avec le directeur de programme.
Je sais. C'est toujours comme ça.
Je sens une nuance de reproche.
C'est pas ça, c'est juste que je te connais.
Tu m'en veux pour le passé.
Mais non.
Mais moi, par contre, je t'en veux encore. Tu t'es pas vraiment bien comporté avec moi.
On n'est pas obligé de se revoir. Si tu veux que je me casse tout de suite.
Non, on se casse pas.
Mais si tu es comme ça, j'ai pas envie de rester.
Reste. Alors Sandrine m'a dit que tu voulais t'installer à Paris.
Je n'ai plus envie de vivre à Londres. Trop de souvenirs.
Et qu'est-ce que tu vas faire maintenant?
Mais je pensais en parler avec toi.
Tu bois quoi?
La même chose, un whisky. Je disais que je pensais en parler avec toi, que peut-être tu pourrais m'aider.
Si tu veux, mais c'est une autre époque.
Oui, une époque où ça marche bien pour toi.
Oui, parce que je fais correctement mon boulot, je suis bonne en politique interne. Mais si j'avais une petite marge de liberté...
Oh non, vraiment, on oublie.
Vous êtes occupée, je voulais juste vous remercier pour l'émission, c'était vraiment formidable.
Oh, merci, c'est gentil à vous.
À vite,
merci beaucoup et à très très vite. Au revoir. Et t'as rien laissé, Ellie?
On n'était pas mariés. On avait un compte commun, presque vite.
Et ton fils?
Mais si je veux le revoir, il faut que je change de vie.
C'est-à-dire?
Que j'ai un boulot, par exemple.
Que t'arrêtes de te défoncer aussi.
Oh non, ça c'est fini.
Ça m'étonnerait.
Vraiment, c'est fini, fini. J'ai fait un traitement à la méthadone, mais j'ai tout arrêté.
Tu sais combien de fois par semaine j'entends ça dans mon bureau? Excuse-moi, hein, mais je te connais depuis suffisamment longtemps et je t'ai assez vu mentir.
J'ai changé.
Les gens changent pas.
Ça, c'est ta morale, pas la mienne.
Bah, Sandrine m'a dit que l'autre jour, t'avais l'air de défoncer quand t'es venue. Tu peux me le dire à moi, je m'en fous, tu fais ce que tu veux.
Elle est jolie, hein, Sandrine. Elle couche avec toi?
Non. Elle m'a plaqué il y a 2 mois.
Tu l'aimes tout chaud? Avant-hier, j'ai suivi toute la soirée.
Elle savait que tu l'as suivie.
Oui, mais elle a fait comme si je n'existais pas. Elle était avec une autre femme avec qui elle a une histoire, je crois. Enfin bon, ça je sais depuis longtemps, ça m'est complètement égal. C'est une fille qui tient un resto près de Beaubourg, mange pas mal. Pas très belle, mais très maternelle. Pas comme moi. Merci. Je te dis, j'ai fait une énorme connerie. M'engueule pas, de toute façon, c'est trop tard. Sandrine est venue me voir pour me faire signer un papier. J'ai inventé un prétexte. Je vais rentrer dans la salle de bain, je vais fermer la porte à clé derrière elle et je me suis tirée.
Non.
Si, si, c'est vrai.
Mais arrête, c'est pas drôle.
Mais t'as plus de 18 ans, tu peux pas faire des choses comme ça.
Bah, oui, c'est normal.
Approche-toi.
Oui, bonsoir. Oui, je voudrais un taxi, s'il vous plaît.
Viens plus près.
Oui, c'est bien. C'est 61, rue du Château, à Boulogne. C'est ça.
D'accord. Ok, merci.
Dit quoi?
Qu'elle m'ouvrait pour la dernière fois.
Tu es sérieuse?
Je suis plus que sérieuse.
Tu l'as tuée?
Ça m'étonnerait, mais si c'est le cas, tant mieux.
le cours. C'est Irène. Elle va appeler toute la nuit pour s'excuser. Vous voulez un whisky? Moi, j'en prends un.
Oui, je veux bien. Après, je m'en vais.
C'est vrai que vous avez été amante avec Irène?
C'est trop bon. Je vais être seule.
Pourquoi pas? Avant d'être avec Lee, vous étiez avec Irène?
Pas avec. Mais oui, on était des amantes.
Et il le savait, Lee?
Oui, bien sûr.
Excusez-moi de vous demander tout ça.
Non, t'excuse pas. Je l'ai jamais caché.
Oh, c'est le plus lourd.
Ça va aller.
Yann et Henri, des copains de Jeff.
Bonjour.
Je te montre ta chambre. Je pensais que tu aurais appelé hier soir.
J'ai vu Irène.
Et ça va marcher?
Non, c'est mort.
Je t'avais prévenu, on peut pas compter sur elle. À 20 ans, c'était déjà une plaie. Ça fait longtemps que je lui parle plus à celle-là. Et ben voilà, tu t'installes. Si les cartons ils te dérangent, tu les mets dans le placard. Ok, ça va aller?
C'est très bien.
La salle de bain, elle est là. Et puis lui, c'est le chien de Jeff. S'il te colle, t'as le droit de le taper. Allez, hop! Dégage. Vous me rejoignez, les garçons?
On finit un truc. À plus.
Ok, à plus. Moi, j'y vais parce que j'ai promis à Jeff d'aller voir les répètes. Tiens, je te file le double des clés. Ça, c'est la maison. Ça, c'est la grille. Si t'as besoin de quelque chose, t'as mon numéro de portable. Ok? Tu fais comme chez toi? Ça va aller?
Plus?
Ouais.
Allez, venez, on y va.
Émilie? Ça va pas, Émilie? Tu veux du Diantalvic?
J'en ai pris. Je voudrais que Lee soit là. Qu'il me prenne dans ses bras pour me dire que tout va bien. Je ne peux plus être seule. Je ne fais que des conneries. pourquoi elle m'a abandonnée.
See you here yesterday.
It was my day off.
Oh, that's why you're here on Sunday.
And I'll be here again next Sunday.
Okay.
I haven't been to see Mrs. Hauser yet.
Well, they promised they'd do a scan today.
What does the doctor say?
Oh, I don't know. I have a bad feeling.
Are you sure the scan is today?
That's what they told me.
That's what they said yesterday and the day before, same thing.
Listen, I don't know. All I can do is repeat what they told me.
I wasn't complaining.
Oh, I'm sorry. Hey. It's me. I'm tense. Oh, yeah, I got it.
How are you doing with Jay?
Oh, fine.
First time you've spent any time with him.
Yes, even with Lee, I didn't take much of an interest until
this. Billy was already a little grown up.
Oh. Kids intimidate me.
Why?
Because they understand everything. They read your thoughts. They know what you're going to say even before you say it.
So, what conclusions has Jay come to?
Oh, he thinks that I'm shy. Bit awkward. Pretty boring. Not that smart. But I'm smarter than he thinks.
Are you?
Yes. He takes coins from my pockets and he doesn't think I notice. But I do. Other than that, he wants to see his grandmother.
Let's wait until tomorrow.
I spoke to Emily.
Who?
Your daughter-in-law. She lives in Paris. She says she's off the drugs. She's getting a job. I think she's having a hard time. I don't know. I feel sorry for her.
Albrecht.
Yes?
I don't want to talk about her.
Of course. But she is Jay's mother, and one day we're going to have to talk.
One day. Not now.
Ronaldo de Machis.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Enchanté. Excusez-moi de vous avoir fait attendre. Je vous le dis sans détour, hein, je vous reçois parce qu'Irène Paolini a beaucoup insisté. C'est vraiment quelqu'un que je respecte beaucoup. Mais je voudrais pas vous faire perdre votre temps. Alors, il faut que les choses soient extrêmement claires entre nous.
Je crois qu'elles sont très claires.
Donc, là, on va ouvrir une nouvelle boutique dans l'espace mode du printemps. On est d'accord que ça implique des responsabilités, mais c'est à peine mieux que de faire vendeuse.
Oui, ça, je le comprends.
C'est un boulot très dur. Et je vais être franc, pas particulièrement bien payé.
J'ai bien réfléchi et ça me convient.
Vous connaissez notre marque?
Bien sûr.
Notre cible, c'est la femme active qui n'a pas accès à des griffes plus prestigieuses, mais qui attend quand même la qualité. C'est pas exactement votre profil.
Non.
L'intérêt, c'est qu'au printemps, il y a une clientèle de touristes, souvent asiatiques. Alors, le fait de parler les langues, c'est clair, c'est un grand plus.
Je vais vous présenter Madame Grégory, c'est elle qui s'occupe de tout chez nous.
Actuellement, elle est en surface, elle surveille l'implantation de la nouvelle collection de lingerie. Bonjour, madame.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Évidemment, ça implique certains efforts de votre part.
Ça veut dire?
Faudra pas venir fringuer comme aujourd'hui. Ou comme quand vous présentiez les clips sur le câble. Ça la foutrait assez mal.
Vous regardiez ça?
Bien sûr, c'était ma génération, hein. C'était vraiment sympa. C'est-à-dire qu'à l'époque, on était très peu à avoir le câble. Alors, il y avait comme un phénomène de tribu, de regroupement comme ça.
Ah, voilà Madame Grégory.
Ouais, ouais, j'allais bientôt partir. Comment ça s'est passé?
Atroce.
Ça n'a pas marché alors?
Si, ça va marcher. Mais de toute façon, je n'ai pas le choix. J'ai appris ça en prison.
T'as appris quoi?
À m'adapter. Si je veux revoir Jay, je dois changer ma façon de vivre, même si c'est une fille de con.
T'exagères, c'est un peu la vie de tout le monde, non?
Mais elle est moche quand même.
Ta vie de junkie, c'est allé mieux?
Je sais pas. Franchement, je ne sais pas.
T'as fait des achats?
Un peu, pour Jay.
Il peut dormir dans le séjour, si tu veux.
Non, t'embête pas. Je vais lui faire un coin dans ma chambre. Il sera très bien.
Mais ça m'embête pas, c'est pour un week-end.
Mais justement, si j'ai que 2 jours, je préfère le garder avec moi tout le temps.
Fais pas trop d'illusions quand même.
Pourquoi tu me dis ça?
Comment ça va se passer quand il faudra la rendre? Il va partir pour Londres. Pour Vancouver, c'est loin Vancouver, non? Excuse-moi d'être dur.
Non, tu as raison. C'est peut-être mieux si je le vois pas du tout, je ne sais plus.
T'as dit pourquoi il venait à Paris, Albrecht?
J'ai écrit pour lui dire que je vais bien. J'ai trouvé un boulot. J'imagine qu'il ne me croit pas. Il veut vérifier.
T'es prête pour l'examen?
J'essaie de changer. Mais je sais pas si je peux m'occuper d'un enfant.
T'as de la monnaie?
Tu t'en souviens que j'étais parlé de Gloria?
La fille que t'as rencontrée en prison?
Elle est sortie.
Je croyais qu'elle en avait pris pour longtemps.
Non, finalement, ils ont annulé toute la procédure. Elle me rappelle la semaine dernière. Elle veut que je vienne.
Où ça?
À San Francisco. Elle a trouvé un label qui aime les maquettes.
Fais gaffe, c'est tourné comme foireux, ces trucs-là. T'as un contrat?
Non, elle n'a pas parlé de contrat.
Y a un peu de thunes au moins?
Ils sont prêts à dépenser un peu d'argent pour refaire les chansons avec un frais producteur.
Ah ouais, c'est qui?
David Roback. T'as du feu?
Non.
Il a un groupe qui s'appelle Mazzy Star. Excusez-moi, monsieur. Vous avez du feu, s'il vous plaît? Merci. Ils ont fait 3 ou 4 disques. Très bien.
Moi, je me souviens de Mazzy Star. Je me souviens de ce mot.
Mais le problème, elle est libre que la semaine prochaine. Faut être en studio lundi. Je dois partir dimanche. Je n'irai pas.
Je sais pas comment le dire, Gloria.
Elle sera très déçue.
Dis-lui que tu verras plus tard.
Non, c'est maintenant ou jamais. Ce qui compte pour moi, c'est Jay. Aller à San Francisco maintenant, ça veut dire tout foutre en l'air.
J'ai déjà trouvé ça dans ma vie et je ne vais pas recommencer.
Excuse-moi. Ah, there you are. Now, did you do
what I said? Did you set your stopwatch?
Oh, yes.
Good. How long have we been in the tunnel?
4:35.
4:35, you're right.
What are we going to do in Paris?
I've already told you 3 times. You're going to see your mother.
Do I have to see her too?
Yes.
Can't you go by yourself?
No.
You didn't tell me I was going to spend a weekend with her.
She's your mother.
She killed my dad.
No, she did not.
Yes, she did. Grandma Rosemary told me so.
Jay, you know it was an accident.
No, it wasn't. He died because he took the drugs she gave him.
Come on. I have to talk to you. Your grandmother and I are old. We won't always be here. What's gonna happen when we're gone?
I haven't finished timing.
Stop. She's your mom. She loves you, and you have to get to know her.
I don't love her, and she doesn't love me either.
Jay didn't want to come.
What do you mean? You promised me.
No, no, no. I didn't promise you anything. I said I'd come to Paris and we'd talk.
No, you said I'd have him all weekend.
If he doesn't want to, I can't force him. It's no good for you either.
He doesn't want to see me.
He doesn't know you.
He hates me.
I don't know. He never talks about you.
I know, but if you told me earlier, I wouldn't have got my hopes so high.
I'm trying to do my best. It's not easy.
I know, me too.
We have to stay in London. Maybe for a few weeks. Give it some time. I'll talk to him. You can come over and see us.
I'm sorry, I can't just. Let's meet another time.
Bonjour,
Miss Linde.
Fumeur ou non-fumeur?
Fumeur.
Monsieur, bonjour. Par ici.
She thinks we're in Scotland. She doesn't know he came with me.
How's she doing?
They're going to do a little operation next week. After that, just depend on the tests. But she seems to think that, well, to be honest, I can't even mention your name in front of her.
Because she thinks that I'm responsible for what happened to Lou.
Yes. That and everything else is declining.
How about you?
I believe in forgiveness. People change. If they need to, they change. But I don't want to hurt Rosemary. If she thought I brought Jay over here for one second, it would tear it apart. I called you back because what you wrote in your letter really moved me.
But you don't trust me.
Does that make any difference? I mean, and I'm old. I won't always be able to look after Jay.
You mean by yourself?
Yeah, that's it. That's exactly it. Without Rosemary. So, have you started your new job?
Yes, I sell clothes for active women at Printemps. It's a department store. But I get the weekends off.
Printemps? Somehow I can't imagine you.
It's better than nothing for now.
You'll find something you love. You'll find something else.
I hope so.
Oh, you will. Wait for me. I have to talk to him first.
If he doesn't want to, then...
No, no, no. Of course. Of course. I'm completely in your hands. If you choose to, you can run off with him. You're his mother. You don't risk much.
I won't.
And you will bring him back by 3:40 train tomorrow afternoon?
Yes.
I'm sorry, Emily. I need you to give me your word.
You have my word.
Okay.
Have you been on a scooter before?
No.
Would you like to try? Come on, you see, it's really fun. Come. Are you scared?
No.
Since you didn't say anything, I thought you were scared.
I'm not scared.
Maybe you're scared of me?
No.
Your granddad said you were scared of me.
No.
Oh, I'm glad to hear it. Hold on tight. Let's go. I was a kid, I only liked tigers and monkeys. Do you like monkeys?
Depends which one.
How about the gorilla?
I seen gorillas.
Where?
In Canada at the Vancouver Zoo.
Oh, come here, look. Is it nice, the Vancouver Zoo?
Much better than this one.
Oh, come on, look at the seagulls.
This one's lame. What's it called again?
It's the Fenzen Zoo. That's the name of the town.
We're not in Paris.
No.
In Vancouver, they have grizzly bears, elks, and beavers.
Maybe they've got some here too. We can ask.
No, I've seen enough of them in Canada. They're everywhere. Once one tried to bite me.
One what?
A beaver.
Are they dangerous?
No, they're really dumb.
Oh, look, there's a baby.
So what do you want to see now?
I want to see a snow leopard with white spots.
A snow leopard, that's a very rare animal.
Yeah.
I'm gonna ask the guy over there. You wait for
okay.
me?
Okay.
Jay? Jay! You think that's funny?
No.
Me neither.
I don't want to spend the weekend with you now.
Why not?
Because you killed my dad.
Is that what you think?
I'm not the only one.
Who else?
Everyone.
I didn't kill your dad.
You gave him drugs that killed him.
It's not true.
And why does everybody say you did?
Because they don't know.
You're a liar.
Come on, let's just get out of here. It was me who went and bought the drugs that night. He took some, I took some. That's the way it was always between us. What's the difference who bought them? Anything could have happened. Could have been Lee losing me. And you know what? Drugs are more complicated than what most people think they are. Some people need them because they're suffering. Because they don't know how to live any other way. Your dad was like that. And me too.
Because you're weak.
No. Your dad wasn't weak. And he did some really great work, but it wasn't easy for him. You have to be very strong to do that. You should be proud of him.
Then how come he needed drugs?
They gave us some really good times. But afterwards, you always have to pay the price. And it's very high. Look at me. I'm still paying.
You're not on drugs anymore.
I gave up. Mainly for you.
Why for me?
Because otherwise, I know I'll never see you again.
Here's the box.
Thank you. I'll show you upstairs our room?
Yeah.
Huh?
is the room Elena lends us. She's really nice. Gonna meet her later.
You don't have your own room?
It was in London.
Then why don't you live in London?
Too many memories.
Memories of my dad?
Yes.
You don't want to remember him?
Yes. But not for now. It's still too painful.
How about later?
Yeah, maybe later. And how about you? Do you like London?
Yes.
More than Vancouver?
Yes. Albert and Rosemary are nice, but they're old and sad.
Because your father died?
Because Rosemary is going to die.
She told you that?
Yes.
I'm gonna make some hot chocolate. Do you want some?
Okay.
Look over there. There's some DVDs. Choose to see if there's one that you want to watch. Go on, over there.
Hey, it's Gloria. Are you there? No, I'm in San Francisco at the Triton Hotel on Grand Street. Remember I told you about it? Please, please, please call me back. David put the sessions off 48 hours to give you one last chance to get here. I don't know what else to say. I'll give you the number. Just a minute. It's,
Can I watch this one?
No way. That's not for kids.
Are you going to San Francisco?
I don't know. I don't think so.
That's where I was born.
Yes.
What's San Francisco like?
It's a beautiful city by the sea. Has a big bridge. You must have seen it in photos now.
If you go, can I come too?
Hey, try one of these. They're really good. Are you sure there's not another film that we can watch? It must be something. Oh, look. Robbie Loren. Have you seen that? Hey. You hurry up, all right?
Okay.
I'll wait here.
Okay.
What, are you bringing him back already?
No, he forgot something.
What?
His hat.
His hat? I thought he had it with him. So how's it going?
Really well.
Yeah? Has he adopted you yet?
Well...
I forgot to take my magazine.
Oh, and your hat. But now you have it.
Yes.
Well, let's pull it down over your ears, otherwise you'll get cold. I've got to talk to your mom, okay? Let's go inside. In you go. What did he get from upstairs?
His passport.
I thought so. Where's he going?
He wants to come to San Francisco with me. I got offered to record some songs there, and it's a chance that's never gonna come back.
So you're giving up?
The clothes were active women at Printemps. Yeah.
Good. I'm glad to hear. being. I think it's brave of you. It's easy to be brave when things go on. But when life is more difficult, it's unusual and special. I'm sure that's what Lee would advise you to do. I have a deal for you.
Do I have a choice?
Of course you have a choice. He's your son. You're his mother. Rosemary is not going to live very long. I want him to stay with her so that she can see him now and then. So, you go to San Francisco and then come join us in London afterwards. Is that okay with you?
Of course.
It's going to be a very difficult time for me and for Jay. He's going to need his mother to protect him. And I'll try and help you rebuild a life, your life, if that's at all possible.
Stand by. I think she's ready. Go ahead and roll it.
I saw it coming to me. You were leaving here tonight. Everybody is an ocean drinking blood from the vine. Go a reason, don't you know it? Round here for everything. There's a lady, she's a killer. Silver me.
maybe we should take a break for a few minutes. Yeah?
You're not tired?
No, I'm fine.
Okay, great.
Turns to gray.
She can tell you why it's getting late. Can't expect her eyes to